The next vitamin is vitamin B5. Vitamin B5. What is the other name of vitamin B5? This is pantothenic acid. Pantothenic acid. As we know, vitamin B complex vitamin are ring structure, but it having no ring. No ring structure. This contains an important amino acid that is beta alanine. Beta alanine. Now, this is a part of coenzyme A. That means this vitamin is a part of coenzyme A, and you must know about the derivative of coenzyme A. Derivative of coenzyme A, and the derivative of coenzyme A is acetyl CoA. Second one is acyl CoA. Third, HMG CoA. And fourth one is succinyl CoA. Why we are concerned with this enzyme? Because this enzyme is basically involved in some process, that is fatty acid oxidation. Fatty acid oxidation. It also involved in citric acid cycle. It also involved in synthesis of cholesterol, that is cholesterol synthesis. Source of vitamin B5, that is pantothenic acid, present in all foods. And remember, pantothenic acid is also synthesized in our body. Our body. Where? In intestine. By the bacterial flora. Bacterial flora present in the intestine that synthesize endogenously pantothenic acid. Now comes with deficiency. Now the pantothenic acid deficiency present with some non-specific symptom like patient complaints of fatigueness, depression. There may be insomnia. And because of this insomnia, the patient may be irritable. That is irritable patient. And the specific symptom is burning foot or burning sole. And the special name and term used for this burning foot and sole is, anyone? Gopalan burning foot or sole syndrome. This is very important. This is associated with the deficiency of vitamin B5. Now, what are the recommended daily allowance for vitamin B5? This is 10 mg per day. But remember, my dear friends, normally from our body, vitamin B5 is excreted per day 3 mg per day. This is generally excreted from the urine because you know vitamin B5 is also a water soluble vitamin. PKAN. What is PKAN? Anyone? Pantothenate kinase associated neurodegeneration. Neurodegeneration. What is this? What is pantothenate kinase associated neurodegeneration? This is basically a autosomal recessive condition. You may get this type of question. This is autosomal recessive condition. What are the other name? Earlier it's known as Heller, Borden, Spass syndrome. Heller-Borden Spass syndrome. What it is? In this, the patient presents with clinical feature of what? Pyramidal tract lesion. Pyramidal tract lesion. Along with that, patient present with mental retardation. What's happened in this? In PKAN. Here, basically, iron containing pigment deposited or accumulated in which part of body? Globus pallidus and substantia nigra. There is, what is deposition is there? Iron containing pigment accumulated in which place? Globus pallidus and substantia nigra. What will happen? Because of this, it will look like hyper intense area within hypointense area. Intense area. And when we see it on MRI, there is decreased T2 signal. And there is decreased T2 signal where? At the same places. Where it is? At globus pallidus and substantia nigra. And what it is? This is hyperintense area within hypointense area. And it looks like, it's look like, what it's look like? Eye of tiger. Eye of tiger. And eye of tiger appearance on MRI is a feature of, that is, pantothenate kinase associated neurodegeneration. Other name is Heller-Borden Spass syndrome. And how actually it's look like? In exam, you may get a image based question, and you can easily appreciate that how it's look like. there is hyper intense area within hypo intense area and look like tiger eye. You may get a similar picture, or you may get these pictures in exam. That is eye of tiger, and this is all about vitamin B5, that is pantothenic acid. Thank you so much.